Hi there, today on Typical Books, we're going to talk about my favorite book, a perfect book. It is a perfect horror book, too, and I'm going to keep it a bit of a secret until the end of the tag, much like Regina tried to in the video where she tagged me. Now, the original perfect book tag came from Bald Book Geek, I believe, and I love that channel as well, and Regina tagged a couple of us. Let me just see here. Edie Lewis Reviews, me, and Matt Wall at Paperback Junkie, channels that I love, so check them all out, and Regina's video as well, where she talks about her Vamp Timber reads. So a perfect book. So when you picture yourself, okay, when I picture myself sitting at a cafe reading a book, and I want to create the picture of me as a bookworm sitting in my natural element with my only prop, this book, this perfect book. The book that if you're being played by some very famous actor in a film and you go to a library or bookstore and you ask for a book or you pick a book off a shelf during a pivotal scene, of course, this is the perfect book. The perfect book. So there's a couple questions here and then I will reveal what the perfect book is, answering them with this particular book in mind. Now you might see a gap in my shelves there, so if you can, if the focus is right and you can see what book is missing off my shelf, you might have a clue there. But yes, first question. What format is your favorite book? Hardback or a paperback or an ebook? And I will say hardcover. Now there is a place for all of those other books. An ebook is perfect if I had to take the bus to my hometown. It's a 5-hour bus ride. Ebooks are grand. Ebooks are great if you're stuck anywhere in any waiting room. It's nice to have a paperback with you, but if you're a bit of a minimalist and don't want to carry books around with you, or like to have them pristine and don't want to lug them around for fear they'll get water damaged or coffee spilt on them or whatever, but a hardcover book is that quintessential thing. It's what I mostly grew up reading when I was younger off my grandmother's shelves, because she had a lot of hardcovers, not so many with the paperbacks. Although horror is mainly found in paperback formats, or the best horror anyway, that tactile thing of hunting old paperbacks at the bookstore, a hardcover book is just a perfect thing. That's my perfect book, a nice, good, well-made hardcover book, and that's what this book is. Question two is, how many pages about is your perfect book? And it's about 250 pages, this particular book. 300 pages is what first comes to mind. 300 pages, whether it be hardcover, paperback, ebook, I like a quick read. When I see a big, thick book, I always feel a little nervous that I either will be investing a whole bunch of time in something I won't like, or what if there's four of them? Like, I'm thinking of The Clan of the Cave Bear, the Jean M. All series. Very large books. There's a lot of big book series. It's just not for me. I like a standalone, like The Stand, let's say. A great big book. That biggest darn book. There's a lot of great big books, but I prefer like something like 300 pages. Question three is, are you particular about where chapters begin? And as far as a design thing, I like a chapter to begin on the right facing page. So page 1, 2, 3, page 3, and then page 17 or something like that. Odd numbered pages. So the right facing book page, that's where I like my chapters to begin. I've seen lots of paperbacks, and to save space and paper, sure, you can begin the chapter after a good blank space, maybe like an inch of blank space to really let you know that's where the chapter ends. And that's fine too, but I prefer them to begin on the odd number or right facing page. Question four is, are you particular as to where the page numbers are located? Kind of. I prefer, and I look to them at the bottom of the page. Way back when my sister was a jerk, she pulled my bookmark out of my book one day and said, "Find your page now, brainiac," and threw my bookmark down. And we weren't even having an argument. She was just being a funny sister, like funny sisters are. And I had inadvertently remembered I was on page 42. It's the answer to life and everything. So yes, I do try and remember what page I'm on in case the bookmark goes missing. which has happened. I've done it to myself. I'm sure you've done it too. But, or maybe you have a jerk sister who would yank your bookmark out of your book as a funny joke. But yeah, I look to the bottom for my page numbers, and that's the way I prefer designing books. When I'm designing books, I like it when all books sort of follow that format, that bookie format. There's a bookie format, and there is a, you know, a traditional book setting format. Many publishing houses have their own kind of protocols, but page number at the bottom centered is what I prefer. Question 5 is favorite font. Do you check to see the font details if available? Yes. Yes. I almost always do. And a few tips here. In the trademark, in the boilerplate type information, you will sometimes find what font it's set in. Some publishing houses use the same font for a specific series or lines or imprints, or sometimes they want to try something new. Palatino is maybe one of my favorites. Baskerville is a close second, and maybe they're tied for first. Palatino is great, very popular font for a lot of books. I don't like Times New Roman. It's such a default. It's such a newspapery font. And I don't know if these psychological things are true for everybody else, but it's true for me. Coming from like a journalism point of view and a design point of view, I really don't like Times New Roman used for books. Never use a sans serif font. If I see a book in a sans serif font, I'm already judging it, really. But yes, I look for the font information. And the big tip, other than where to find font information, if it's not there and you really want to know, if you like the shape of that Q, Kate Hartfield has some great fantasy and darker books out that have really cool fonts, and there's a really cool font that she was hunting for. And this is a trick from Design Times, and I've used it in journalism as well. When you want to identify a font, there is a website called What the Font, and you can upload a photo of the font you want to know what it is, and it will usually tell you bang on what it is, especially if it is a trademark house font. If it comes from one of the great font houses that we all know and love, like Frutiger, Helvetica, Baskerville, Garamond, one of those big font families, or typeface, it's really typeface. The font is the size of the typeface, let's say, to be technical about it all. But yeah, What the Font, if you want to know what the font that font is, you look up What the Font. What the Font is part of myfonts.com. I don't know what font my perfect book is set in, so I will run it through some What the Font at the end of the video and find out. Question 6 is, do margins matter to you? Yeah, you want to be able to hold the book where your thumb doesn't cover any of the writing. That's really my guide. If margins are too tight or the line spacing is too tight, I already feel like I'm doing too much work. I like a little bit of air around each line and a lot of air on the margins, and they should all match. I know that bookbinding sometimes can be a mysterious and dangerous thing where it ruins a lot of your pagination, as it's called, or the way that your pages are set up, but I like to have at least a good thumb width in the margin so you can hold the book open and not cover any of the type. Question 7 is, does your favorite book have any unique features that make it perfect? Yes, it's black. It is black. I don't like white, red, all these multicolored books just ruin the aesthetic. And I, you know, in the person playing me in my movie about me, I want to see them reading a black book, a black hardcover book. Sure, it can have text on it and stuff, and it can have filigree and it can have gold foil or whatever, but I'd really prefer black. And if you want to go beyond that, I want to have interesting type elements. You can have a plain set Trajan Pro, very popular font face, or like Times New Roman or whatever font you want, Arial, Helvetica, as the spine text, but I'd rather something a little more interesting and a little bit of design, a little bit of like filigree or a little bit of some sort of flourish to dress it up a little bit. And as far as the page edges, I would love them to be black stained as well. Indeed, my favorite book is black stained edges, and it's gorgeous. I love the look of that particular book. If all books had to be black hardcovers with black stained edge, I would be the happiest girl in the world. My favorite book that I actually have here with me has an even more unique feature that isn't something that could be found in other books. It's got a very interesting cover. Question 8 is show us the cover. Here is that interesting cover of James Herbert's The Rats. This is glow in the dark. It's gorgeous. It has text on the stained edges as well. And there's a little bit of glow in the dark there as well. It's just very plain. It has nothing exciting about it. There was no dust jacket. I hate dust jackets. That's a bonus question. Do you hate dust jackets? Yeah, I do. But it's got I guess it's a step back cover of the rats. And that's the glow in the dark portion. You can see all the little rat eyes. It is just a beautifully made book. So beautifully made. Just gorgeous. And I had seen it on the shelves for about a year at the bookstore before I bought it, because I thought, you know what, I think I want to have the paperback of this like you would have when it first came out, but this anniversary edition is gorgeous. A special 40th anniversary edition of the classic best-selling novel that launched James Herbert's career. It was only when the bones of the first devoured victims were discovered that the true nature and power of these swarming black creatures with their razor-sharp black teeth and taste for human blood began to be realized by a panic-stricken city. For millions of years, man and rats have been natural enemies, but now for the first time, suddenly, shockingly, horribly, their balance of power had shifted. The Rats by James Herbert. And it is also a perfect horror novel. It's kind of the beginning of splatter as we know it, and it's very formulaic in a way. It also has a little bit of B-grade schlockiness to it, a little bit of unbelievable characters and bad science, but hey, it's a gorgeous book. It's a super fun read, a super quick read. I highly recommend The Rats for this Halloween season. But yeah, and anytime, you know, absolutely anytime. If you can hunt down this 40th anniversary Penn Macmillan version, it is just gorgeous. And it glows in the dark. I mean, hello. I couldn't put that into the list really, because how many books do you have on your shelves that glow in the dark? Maybe one or two? Maybe none. Most of us probably have none. I have at least this one, and it is perfect. So as promised, I'm going to take a photo of the text on my phone and go to myfonts.com. What the font is part of myfonts.com. Make sure that the pages are not bent when you're taking the photo, so it's nice and flat and it gets a pretty good image of even one word. So I took the picture and I've just uploaded it. It says, hang tight while we find text in your picture. And it analyzes particular letters to see how they match up like fingerprints to specific fonts. And the verdict is Century Old Style Roman. Century is a very popular font, and I've seen a lot of magazines use Century. There are other fonts. Of course, this is the Roman Old Style. There's a bold, probably, and maybe a display version of Century. Century I've seen used in magazines quite often as well. So just a very popular font, probably very popular in a lot of books that we read as well. A little bit on Linotype as far as a font house. For over a century, Linotype has successfully produced, marketed, and licensed quality fonts. Its proven methods have been expanded over the years, adapting to new technologies, as fonts are a vehicle for visual communication. Linotype partners with both designers and typographers who together promote global transfer and open discussion. The Linotype font library is owned by Monotype and includes renowned fonts such as Helvetica, New Helvetica, Linotype Dido, Janssen, Text New Century Schoolbook, and more. Some very, very heavy hitters. There is a documentary on Helvetica if you're interested in fonts and how they're produced and why. It's a fantastic documentary if you want to watch a documentary about fonts. Because I know I do. Indeed, students of journalism are urged to watch the Helvetica documentary. And I had a quiz for my students that only dealt with the first like 20 to 30 minutes of it. Because if they didn't like sitting through it, at least they'd be guaranteed they could answer all the quiz questions by only watching a little bit of it. But most of them found that this documentary was fascinating anyway. So I hope you found the favorite book tag. Thank you, Regina, for tagging me in the perfect book tag. This is, to me, a perfect book. I don't know who I would like to tag in this. Sean Standfast, I believe, is the one person I'd love to see do this if he hasn't already. I'm going to take a look through his videos to see if he hasn't already done this particular tag, but I'd love to hear what his perfect book is. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what your perfect book is, and have an ooky, spooky day.